Something in your kitchen is killing you. That's the latest in the health findings. We're going to tell you about it on this program. You don't want to miss it. But in case you have any investments, Wall Street has gotten off to a rough start this year, with the Dow Jones already down 7%. And now investors are asking, what's coming up next?
Well, some experts say that the market has more ups and downs ahead of it before stocks finally regain their footing. Charlene Israel has the story.
It's been a rough, scary ride for stocks so far in 2014, with the market on a roller coaster ride and down more than 5% for the year already. Monday, U.S. stocks were hammered. The Dow Jones average dropped more than 300 points, its biggest decline since June of 2013. The Standard & Poor's lost 40 points, and the Nasdaq dropped 2.6%. One reason? A report showed that U.S. manufacturing barely expanded last month, dropping to an 8-month low.
The weather emerged as a common problem for the economy last month. Cold and snow grinded small businesses to a halt. Investors worried that could have a spillover effect on jobs.
Many stock watchers took the market's decline in stride, calling Monday's action just a recalibration following record highs at the end of last year.
Based on today's close, the S&P 500 is now in a pullback mode, meaning it's declined between 5 and 10%. My belief is that we probably won't go beyond the 10% zone.
Fresh signs of weakness in China also weighed on the minds of investors. Any signs of slowdown in China's economy, the world's second largest, can spell bad news because it's a key trading partner for developing countries such as South Africa and Indonesia. Indeed, Japan sold off sharply today, and there's even concern that some countries could fall into severe recessions where deflation hits and prices start to fall while unemployment rises. For now, most analysts think we are only seeing a temporary pullback in prices that isn't over yet.
I think investors are now worried that global economic growth could be hindered.
But analysts still expect stocks to rise in the longer term. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Thanks, Charlene. I think, folks, what we're dealing with is an incredible overhang of debt. There's debt everywhere. There's debt in Argentina, and there's debt in Brazil, and there's debt in the Soviet Union, and there's debt in the United States that is staggering. And sooner or later, those debts are going to have to be paid off. And who's going to pay them off? Where is the ultimate source? The United States has been the ultimate source, but no longer. So what's going to happen? So there's going to be, when we have a retrenchment finally, it's going to be ugly. So I would caution, you know, urge caution. I think we don't need to have any wild gambles these days. This is the time for retrenchment and care, because when somebody pulls the plug, it's going to be ugly. Well, the political crisis in Ukraine has been in the news. What hasn't been in the news is how Christians in Ukraine are responding. We have a major presence in that country and a big studio in Kiev. And John Jessup has that story from Washington. Here's John.
Pat, that's right. Protest leaders in Ukraine are seeking constitutional reforms to make changes in their government. The parliament took up those measures today. Meanwhile, in the midst of all the political strife, Christians are spreading the gospel. George Thomas brings us that story.
All eyes are on the Ukrainian parliament today as lawmakers debate the constitution as well as presidential powers. And while they meet, tens of thousands of Ukrainians continue to demonstrate on the streets of Kyiv, as they have done so since last November, demanding that the Ukrainian president, Viktor Yanukovych, step down from power. This was as a result because he decided to rebuff on a multi-billion dollar deal that would have brought closer relations with the European Union. This past Sunday, as thousands were gathering on Maidan, on Independence Square, the epicenter of the political crisis, hundreds of Christian volunteers also fanned out. They had a mission. They had 15,000 copies of the Gospel of John to hand out.
People are looking to the politicians to solve our crisis, but we're here to say it's not politics, but Jesus Christ who is the answer for Ukraine.
And since last November, the churches here in Ukraine have been actively involved. They've seized the opportunity to speak truth and hope into the political crisis. Churches have held 24-hour prayer vigils. They've conducted numerous evangelistic outreaches. CBN Kiev has been actively involved, as they have been for the last 20 years, using television and other evangelistic tools to share the gospel of Jesus Christ.
One of the things that's exciting to me is that we are not embarrassed to name the name of God, not embarrassed to name the name of Jesus Christ. We've got placards down there on Maidan of saying, pray to Jesus. Jesus has the future for our nation. And they're praying from the stage down there morning and night. They open up every morning with the Lord's Prayer.
CBN News had an exclusive interview with the former head of the Ministry of Defense here in Ukraine. He told me how encouraged he was by the role the church was playing.
All churches, all denominations, with no exceptions, they are here. They are spreading an important message on those barricades. And when the police started to attack, it was the Christians who stood and called for peace.
As I have spent time here on the streets of Kiev, meeting with demonstrators, but also more importantly with the church, they say they will continue to speak hope and lay the foundation, those biblical foundations that they pray will one day bring peace and prosperity to their nation. George Thomas, CBN News, Kiev, Ukraine.
Here at home, just as the East Coast is barely digging itself out of a winter storm, half of the country is getting another round of icy weather. 25 states are under winter watches or warnings, preparing for a week of snow, ice, and rain. The snowfall begins this afternoon in the Midwest, then the Northeast will get more snow this evening and into early Wednesday, making it harder for football fans trying to leave after the Super Bowl.
With the weather getting so bad, I called this morning and got an earlier flight. And then it got delayed, and then it got delayed, and now it's delayed again.
More than 1,000 flights have been canceled across the country today. Pat?
Well, you know, the thing that is so amazing, folks, it's been pointed out, and I'll just add a little exclamation point, too. We had a spate of several weeks of icy cold, sub-zero weather in many parts of the country, terrible snowstorms, icy roads, and wintry conditions. Okay. Now it's returning to wintry conditions, icy roads, heavy snowstorms, blizzard conditions. But that one time they had a Super Bowl and suddenly it got warm down here. The temperature was like 60 degrees and the sky is cleared and they had a marvelous time and then it all closed down again. I hate to think that the Lord is in favor of football one way or the other, but certainly.
I like to think of that as a given.
From Green Bay, of course you
exactly.
do. Well, in any event, whatever it was, I think it's an amazing thing, and it was a nice thing for our country to have something that made them happy. John?
Pat, while much of the country is dealing with snow and ice, California is going through an historic drought that could turn out to be the worst in 500 years. The state is already facing the worst water shortage in more than a century. And with little to no rain this year, the drought is hurting residents and farmers. And as Caitlin Burke reports, it soon could affect the rest of the country.
California is running out of water. Parched fields, starving livestock, and near empty water reservoirs led Governor Jerry Brown to declare a drought emergency. That was 2 weeks ago, and today, still no rain.
Simply put, there's not enough water to go around.
On Friday, state officials announced that there's no water left in the main distribution system, and they won't be delivering any water to local agencies this year. Instead, they'll be forced to rely on other supplies.
Today's actions mean that everyone, farmers, fish, people in our cities and towns, will get less water as a result. But these actions will protect us all better in the long run.
The move affects more than 25 million people, most notably California's farmers.
The citrus belt, the grapes, the nuts, all of them is the east side. When you take them to zero water allocation, which is what's going to happen here, it's going to be a major crisis for those cities.
The impact could spread across the country, pinching the nation's food supply.
This year, we'll see maybe a little less product or maybe a little smaller. If we have another year like this, though, it will be a tragedy.
California has already experienced 3 years of below normal rain and snow. Now, 17 communities and water districts are within 100 days of completely running out of water. Governor Jerry Brown is asking everyone to do their part to conserve.
Don't flush more than you have to. Don't shower longer than you need to. And turn the water off when you're shaving or brushing your teeth.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
Pat, some pretty tough times there weather-wise in California.
I tell you what, up in the San Joaquin Valley, that's like the breadbasket of America. They have so many fruits and vegetables that come out of that area, the whole nation, and billions of dollars are agricultural produce. If that water is cut off to those farmers and we don't have that, it'll skyrocket prices, and not only run prices up, we won't be able to get things that we're used to eating. It'll be a major hit on the United States. Now, Jerry Brown, as I saw this today, is proposing a canal from up in the San Francisco, north of San Francisco, to bring it down to the southern part of the state. And of course, there are opponents to say, what's that going to do? It might alleviate, it might not, and they're not sure. But it's a major problem. And you might not like what comes out of California all the time, but if there's ever a time, you need to pray about it. I mean, your own interests are at stake, and I think we should pray for them to have the water they need, because there's some good people up there in that area, in the San Joaquin Valley and around that agricultural belt. Bakersfield and on up, and it's a crisis. I don't want to be alarmist, but the worst in 500 years sounds pretty bad to me, John.
Pat, the world could be facing a record number of new cancer cases in the next 20 years. The World Health Organization says the number of cases will rise by 57%. The agency's report says about half of those cancers could be prevented by focusing on issues like obesity, drinking, and smoking, along with encouraging exercise and screening programs. Well, too much sugar literally could be deadly for you. The biggest study yet says it doesn't take all that much extra sugar to substantially raise the risk to your heart. Much of that sugar is hidden in many processed foods, and most Americans eat more than the safest amount. Just drinking two 12-ounce cans of soda substantially raises the risk of heart problems for people who normally eat 2,000 calories a day. And the link between sugar and heart problems doesn't apply just to the overweight. It also was found in people who register at normal weights. The safest amount of sugar to eat is less than 10% of your daily calories. That would be under 200 a day for people who eat 2,000 calories. And Pat, you got to wonder what it will eventually take to shift people's attitudes towards added sugars.
Well, the problem, John, is that it's hidden. This high fructose corn syrup is in almost everything, and it's hidden. You don't know that it's there. Especially it's in our cereal. We think we've got to entice little children into eating cereal. So we've got Cap'n Crunch and Sugar Pops and all these various things that are just loaded with sugar. Now, I have in front of me something just to show you what it's going to be like. Grief, I never make it scoop an ice cream.
Well,
this thing doesn't have one of those little deals, does it?
No, I think you just gotta.
It won't work.
Use both fingers.
I'm sorry. I'm all right. There's that much of that. Now, where's my spoon?
Okay. Oh, there's your. Look,
oh, this is my spoon. All right. What I just did there is how many is that? Let's see now. I've got to pay them. That is five. Teaspoons right there.
Five teaspoons of sugar in one scoop of ice cream.
One scoop of ice cream in there. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, there's that awful looking little thing I just dumped in there.
Yeah.
One little scoop of ice cream, chocolate ice cream, and that's how many it is. Now, this is. You know, a soda. I asked for a Coke, but they don't even want to advertise Cokes on the show. I don't know where in the world nobody would drink this stuff. But in any event, wherever they got it,
I think they do.
Well, could you give me a measuring cup, somebody?
Here we go. You're.
Oh,
David,
thank
just bring
you.
It
oh,
in.
I'm so glad. This is sort of spur of the moment. This is the handy can of Cokes, and you know it's the real thing. It's the pause, it refreshes, and all that stuff. This is a standard can of Coke, and it has, what does it have, Terry? Let's see.
Let's see what you got here.
Okay.
9 teaspoons of sugar, all right, about 140 calories.
This one can of Coke, one can. All right, put that in there.
Whoa.
I'll give this to Dr. Oz when I'm finished.
Yeah. I think it may explode before that.
There's a can. Okay. Now, how many of this thing?
That says 9 teaspoons of sugar.
9?
So,
all right.
One,
two, three.
Ooh, it's fizzing.
Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight.
Good grief.
9. Now, and that's that one scoop of ice cream plus a Coke I have put in.
Let's see, you've got 9 and 13. Oh, no, that's the cinnamon roll. 9. And what did you put in with the scoop of chocolate ice cream? 5.
Yeah.
So 14.
You've 14,
14 teaspoons of sugar.
Teaspoons of sugar. And the little guidelines are a couple a day if you're going to be healthy.
Wow.
And then, of course, they have these things.
Look at those cinnamon rolls.
Oh, brother. All right. I'm not going to throw that in that mess, but in any
way.
I'll let you eat one of them.
At this stage. All right.
This looks so tasty. This does not come from Cinnabon. Maybe it does, but anyhow, it's a cinnamon roll with all the stuff in it. Okay. Now, how many keys?
Okay, the cinnamon roll. Oh, 13 teaspoons.
All right, let's go for that, and then.
I think you left your teaspoon.
All right, 13. That one little.
13. Well, that's not exactly a little roll, you think?
Well, yeah, it's what you'd get if you went to Cinnabon.
Well,
one.
I think cinnamon's is bigger,
two,
actually.
Look
three.
At that, three.
I know.
Four.
It's making me kind of sick.
Yeah. This is what you're getting. 5.
I don't need that.
6.
7.
How many?
13. 8.
9.
Ooh.
10. 11. 12.
Sort of like a
13.
Concocting the drug of your choice, right?
The bowl is full up with sugar. Now, when you add it all together, oh my goodness, it's all falling.
Don't let him in your kitchen, people.
No, please
don't let him in your kitchen.
You wouldn't want me doing it. But this is a standard breakfast. Somebody's going to have, you know, a cinnamon roll.
Mm-hmm,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll have a cup of coffee. And
with
then
sugar in it, probably.
With sugar in it. And then they go out and they may have a Coke, you know, or two Cokes.
Or two.
And it's small one. This is giving us heart condition. This is causing inflammation. It is causing diabetes. It is causing Alzheimer's. And that is, and on top of this, our dear, wonderful government, the taxpayer's friend, is subsidizing the people who grow sugar, especially those Cubans down in the South, the farmers who've come into this country, and they've got huge sugar plantations in Florida. They get subsidies. We subsidize foreign corporations to grow sugar, to keep the price of sugar high, so the American people have to pay a lot. Not only does it kill them, but they get sick. So,
deadly.
I should never do demonstrations on television, but anyhow, you get the point.
Not without a bib.
Not without a counter. Thank goodness you were counting. All right, that just shows you what you're doing to yourself, though.
Yeah.
One Coke, one cinnamon roll, one scoop of ice cream.
And there are alternatives. You know, I know a lot of people interested in health who are using stevia now, just those little drops. And
I'm a stevia fan. Absolutely. Stevia is natural, and little teeny bits of it's got all the sweetener you need. But as far as you've got to stop drinking Cokes, you've got to stop drinking sweetened drinks. And whether it's Orange Crush or whatever it is, and these sugary food, I have berries, unsweetened, delicious.
Yes.
Frozen berries, mixed berries. You can get them at Price Club or Costco. And I have nuts.
Is that your breakfast every day?
That's it.
And I thought you ate oatmeal.
Well, I have oatmeal along with the nuts.
Yeah.
I have oat bran oatmeal and sometimes a 7-grain cereal. And maybe I put a little syrup in it. But in any event, you can put stevia on it.
Absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
Let's be healthy. I want you to live longer. We need you.
A federal judge in Norfolk, Virginia, is considering whether the state's ban on same-sex marriage is constitutional. Virginia voters approved a constitutional amendment in 2006 defining marriage as a union of a man and woman. Now homosexual couples are suing to overturn the will of the people, and Virginia's newly elected Democratic Attorney General has decided to join their case instead of defending the law. Conservatives argue he's abandoned his duty to uphold the state's laws. The judge in today's hearing was appointed by President Obama. The Islamic terrorist group Boko Haram is being blamed for the death of a pastor in Nigeria. The group this weekend launched an attack on a predominantly Christian village. The gunman targeted a church. 10 other worshipers were also killed. The Al-Qaeda-linked Boko Haram is responsible for thousands of deaths in Nigeria over the last several years. The group has caused thousands of Christians to flee. You can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.